not been able to keep on with producing sugar. And as you have already noted, Mumias Sugar Board of Management suspended Chief Executive Nashon Aseka over what they termed as doubtful transaction at the struggling mill barely a year after he was appointed. And as we were speaking on Tuesday to the board chairman, Kennedy Ngumbau, he said that the decision was reached out during a special board meeting, which also happened on Tuesday. And as already have noted, the suspension was that some doubtful transactions appear to have taken place without following due process and even the requisite approval. So they say that the decision to suspend Aseka was meant to pave way for further investigation into the matter. And as you have noted, Mumias is one of the leading sugar processing factory in Western region, and it used to be the East African nation's leading sugar producer, and with more than 250,000 tons a year. So the main question that remains, what other actions will the board of management take in regard to reviving the dying sugar factory, which is Mumias? And also, we are being informed that currently there is another board meeting which is still underway. We don't know what they're discussing, but we hope to get more information by the end of the day after the meeting ends. And we also know that the board of directors of the country's only listed NSE-listed sugar miller, which is Mumias Sugar Company, also appointed Agriculture Patrick Chebot as the acting chief executive, but also questioned as still being asked why they decided to appoint Patrick Chebosi, even though that is rumored he was only employed 2 weeks ago. So people are still asking, farmers are still asking, will he be able to work on in the same position that Aseka was holding, especially that we know he's not so much experienced with Mumias Sugar Company. And maybe to give a little bit of information to our viewers, that Mr. Aseka was appointed June last year following the shock resignation of Australian Errol Johnston 4 months before the end of his two-year renewable contract in August 2017. And Aseka's appointment also came 2 months after he had been rejected by Nzoia Sugarcane Farmers, where he had been named as the CEO in April in 2017. So it seems that all these individuals who have been appointed to lead Mumias Sugar have had troubles before, and as Aseka has been sent home to wait until a further decision is made, we also want to see if Patrick Chebot will be able to sustain Mumias Sugar Company, that we know currently it owes farmers about 600 million shillings and also requires 20 billion shillings to settle debts with growers, banks, staffs, and even other taxmen. So, Betty, we don't know what the board is tending to achieve after it suspended Aseka, because we also know that Mumias Sugar is not receiving any sugarcane from farmers, because now there's no any service that is taking place from there. And also, they owe a lot of money to the same farmers, whom some of them have decided not to continue farming or to plant sugar. Some of them have already uprooted their sugarcane, and they are thinking of maybe venturing into maize planting or any other cash crop so far. But we are still waiting to find out what the board of management will discuss today, and maybe their final decision, and maybe which step they will take further to make sure that Mumias Sugar Factory continues with its processes.
All right. Willie Lusige, thank you for that.